So tell me a little bit about, like, if you're looking at your body of work and you see the difference between doing a broadcast series and then a streaming series, is one more fun than the other, more liberating than the other, make you panic because you just never know with a with a series? Sometimes they call them limited series because they just don't know, right? I'll call it a limited series until we're going to make it not limited, you know? What is it like living on that edge?
It's such a great question. I think that both with Judging Amy, which was my baby, and then Private Practice, which I was so blessed to do for 6 years, both of those were network shows. And as much as the characters can stretch and grow, if you are a lead in a network show, you pretty much have to stay on this side of likable. You just kind of do. And yet within that, you can have lots of humanity. And, you know, in Judging Amy, we did so many different things in Private Practice too. And that's Shonda Rhimes' genius. But I remember, you know, the first non-network show I did was The Leftovers. And I remember thinking, oh, there's no safety net. And in fact, I had to catch up with that. And Damon Lindelof, the writer on that, and I talk about this to this day, because the first season of The Leftovers, I was still a little bit hanging on to being likable. I just kind of couldn't go as far as I really wanted to go. And as he was sort of asking me to go, by the end, I got there. And now I'm fully in those deep waters. And I could give a crap whether I'm likable or not. I just want to be truthful. It's also getting older. I mean, it's also getting older.
Yes.
Every cliche is true. And so it's like when you're like a love interest and you're younger and you're the ingenue, even when you're playing a young mother, it's like there's something archetypally, like you just have to be sort of appealing. And I think the beauty of being past that, and the beauty of streaming, you know, we didn't have those options, especially for women, even 10 or 15 years ago. But now we have really complex women, all sorts of characters that are way beyond any models that have come before. It's really exciting.
Yeah. I just love that. I mean, I think about Weeds, and there's a mom who's a drug dealer, right? And she's lovable, hateable. I think about all these great characters that we've only been able to get streaming. But you have such a great point about, you know, with age and wisdom come some of the laugh lines and the crow's feet, but it also gives us a WTF kind of approach to whatever it is. I remember in the 80s trying to be a news anchor, and I thought I wasn't allowed to move. Right? If my shoulders went to the left or right, I'd have been like making somebody angry. And it's now, are you kidding me? I'll drink a glass of wine on the air.
No, exactly. And it seems like, I don't know if you would find this, but the more I don't care if people like me, the more they do. Or if they don't, it's fine too. Yeah. But there's an authenticity to moving through the world. You know, you're just not. And I felt like I was pretty free from that even coming into Hollywood. But I think just culturally, you know, we're it's like I hope people like me, and I hope I keep my job. And I mean, that was also the big breakthrough for me of having my own shop. I mean, Judging Amy, it's like, what are they gonna do, fire me? It's like, I am the boss, you know.
You were not only the boss being the star, but you were like the executive producer as well, and the creator. So you're right, it's a little harder to do that. And
it took me a while to realize I could fire people, and we helped a couple people I should have fired, actually, you know. But I wasn't quite there yet. I was still like, oh, I'm the boss, but I want to be a likable boss. And I was a really good boss. But I think that next step of being a really good leader, which is making hard decisions and all that, that comes.
Let me ask you this.